to Sage X3 short video tutorial. So in today's session, I'm going to talk about the standard cost calculation and specifically the fixed cost distribution field within that standard cost calculation function. So for the agenda I have, what is the difference between the fixed cost distribution selections that are pro rata versus total? And let's look at the setup of the production bill of material, routing, and product site records for this purpose. And finally, we'll calculate the standard cost and then analyze the about two options to see how the system calculates the fixed cost distribution when it is set to pro rata versus when it is set to total. So basically, I have a multi-level BOM. So the finished good has a EOQ of 100, and it has a component and a semi-finished good, which has an EOQ of 50. And the semi-finished good has a two components, component 2 and 3. Alright, so let's continue. So basically, I have for the semi-finished good, the setup time is 5 hours and the runtime is also 5 hours, and the base quantity is 1. And then for the work center, I have a labor and a machine. So the labor has a standard setup rate of 30 and a run rate of 40. And the machine has a setup rate of 10 and a run rate of 20. Additionally, I also have an overhead on the routing. Still for the machine, I have an overhead of $10 and a labor overhead of $20. And then for the finished good, we have a setup time of 2 hours and the runtime of 2 hours. The work center for the finished good also is same as the work center for the semi-finished good, so the rates are the same, and also the overhead is also the same, so it's $10 and $20. And for the product site, I have the EOQ of the semi-finished good at 50, and then the component standard cost is 25, component 3 standard cost is 75, and for the finished good, EOQ is 100 and the component 1 standard cost is 50. So then let's before we interpret the results, I'll just quickly show you the system, how we have the setup for the product side and the routing, especially so that you will understand a little clearly. So let's go to first the multi-level BOM. So it's on the common data, bill of materials, and in production bill of materials. So I have the two bill of materials. One is the finished good, FRN 066, and the base quantity is 1. Has two components. One is a semi-finished good and the other one is the raw material. Each has a unit of measure link quantity of 1. And then for the routings, as I mentioned before, it's in hours, and if I look at the routing operation detail screen, we have the two work centers, and setup time is set to 2 hours, runtime is 2 hours. And within the work centers, I have a costing dimension of with the overhead of $10, and the standard setup rate is 10, and the standard run rate is 20. That is for the machine work center. And then for the labor work center, I have the same setup, except that the overhead is a different code, but it's for $20 plus the standard setup is 30 and the standard run is 40. So these are the main setups on the routing that I wanted to show you. And next, let's look at the product site record. So for the product site records, the main product is FIN066. I have a EOQ of 100, technical lot 100, and the standard cost here is got calculated already. For the what do you call the other item semi-finished, I have the EOQ of 50. Right, and then the raw materials, the standard costs have already been calculated or entered. So 50, and then for the so the component one is 50, component two is 25, component three is 75. All right, so let's quickly run a calculation, cost calculation. So it's under costing, standard cost calculations, select the site, select the product, the finished good, and I'm going to leave the calculation quantity as 100 because that's the EOQ quantity which gets defaulted. And the bill of material type is manufacturing, the routing code. Check the calculate all bill of material levels because it's a multi-level bill of material, and the fixed cost distribution. So this is the field that I wanted to illustrate today. So here we have two options. One is pro rata, other one is total. So if I run the pro rata, select the report, any item cost, preview it. So I get this mention, no economic quantity for the pro rata distribution, which is fine because this product is a phantom product, so there is no economic quantity on it. Alright, so let's look at the report. So this is the NA item cost report, which shows us the unit cost of the finished semi-finished good here. So you can see the fixed cost distribution is pro rata and the calculation quantity is 100, and you can see for the components, the standard cost of the phantom item component 2 is 25 and the standard cost of the component 3 is 75. So the total material cost is 100. So when it comes to the operations, so we have the labor and the machine work centers. So we have to focus on the setup time calculation and the run rate cost calculations plus the overheads. So you can see how the system has calculated when it is set to pro rata. Right. So the main difference between the pro rata versus the total is for pro rata system uses the EOQ quantities, and for the total it doesn't use the EOQ quantities, so it uses the calculation quantities. And also for the setup side, you know, you can see how the system uses the EOQ, and then for the runtime it uses the calculation quantity, and for the overhead it also uses the EOQ plus the calculation quantity. So I'll just show you the calculations on a different slide, but you know, this is how you run the cost calculations, and then you would select the fixed cost distribution, whether you wanted to run it for pro rata versus total. So you know, that's how you would run it, by selecting either options. Okay, and taken some screenshots to show you how the what's the difference between the when it is set to pro rata versus when it is set to total. So let me go back to my slide. You can see I have calculated the any item cost report for a pro rata distribution of 100 quantity, so the one I just showed you earlier, and this is the setup time cost and the runtime cost plus the overheads, and then the semi-finished total cost, total unit cost. So here I have the operation calculations when the fixed cost distribution is pro rata. So for the semi-finished good, the setup cost comes to $4. So the rules to calculate how the system calculates the pro rata is it takes the fixed quantity times the ratio times the cost divided by the calculation quantity. So in my example, I have a setup time of 5. That is the fixed rate, and then fixed time plus times the ratio where the calculation quantity is 100 divided by the EOQ quantity of 50 times 30 is the rate. So you can see here the rate is 30 and the time is 0.10. So when you multiply the time by the rate, it comes to $3 for the labor and $1 for the machine. So over here you can see how the calculations for the setup time is, and for the runtime, you know, we use the runtime of 5 times the calculation quantity of 100, and then times the rate for the runtime for the labor, and then the runtime rate for the machine, and then divide that by the total calculation quantity of 100. Okay, and for the overheads, we have the setup time of 5 and the EOQ of 50 and the overhead rate of $10 for the machine, and then plus you have the runtime calculation of 5 times 100 times the $10 overhead rate divided by 100. So when you add this section to this section, you get $51 for the machine, and then for the labor is $102. So you can see for the pro rata, it is using the EOQ of 50 on the overhead side as well as on the setup time side. Okay, so let's continue to the pro rata of the finished good. So the finished good, you can see here the component of semi-finished good total of 557 is displayed here, and then the raw material of 50, the standard cost, is displayed here. So the total component cost of the finished good here is $607, and then we have the operations cost, and the calculations are the same as what we saw on the semi-finished goods. Right, so the calculation you can see here, the change here is that the setup time of the finished good is 2 hours versus the semi-finished good is 5 hours. And then also the EOQ of the finished good is 100. So there are 2 changes on the finished good side, and accordingly you can see the calculations change. Alright, so this is how the system calculates the setup time, runtime, overhead cost. And for the total, so you know, when I run the standard cost calculation with the fixed cost distribution set to total, you know, the calculations, the way the system calculates the setup time, runtime, and overhead are different to the calculations of the pro rata. So here you can see the fixed cost distribution is equal to total, and the semi-finished good has an E of Q of 50, but for the total calculations, there is the system doesn't consider the E of Q amount or the E of Q values. So the rules for the total calculation is the fixed quantity times the cost divided by the calculated quantity. So the fixed cost or the fixed, I have the setup time of this operation is 5 times the rate 30 divided by 100 is $1.50, and then for the machine is 50 cents. And for the runtime, we have the same calculations, because here we don't use the EOQ for the runtime for either the prorata or the total. And for the overheads, you can see here again the EOQ is not considered. So the overhead calculations are here below. Setup time divided by the calculation quantity times the overhead rate plus the setup time times the calculation quantity times the rate divided by 100. So the overhead for the machine is $50.50, and overheads for the labor is $101. So here is the total for the finished good, and the calculations of that is here below. So you can see, you know, the how the system calculates the total, which we just saw from the semi-finished good side. And then finally, I just took some comparison screenshots, so you can see for the semi-finished good, the machine cost, labor cost, and the overhead cost. For the EOQ, when it is set to prorata, EOQ of 50 for the semi-finished good, and for the total, the total for the total calculation, the calculation quantity is 100. So you can see the difference of values for the total versus the prorata, and the EOQ 50 and the calculation quantity of 100. But if you look at the finished good, you can see the EOQ is 100 and the total calculation quantity is 100. So here we can see these costs, the machine labor and overhead costs, do have the same values, because here the prorata we are using a quantity EOQ 100, but for the total also we are using a calculation quantity of 100, right? So that's why we see that same values here. But if I run the calculation quantity for a total distribution, fixed cost distribution, then calculated quantity of 200, you can see the values change slightly. So I just thought of putting it here just so that it's easy to kind of compare the difference between, you know, when you select the fixed cost distribution pro rata versus a total. All right, so I think that's all I have, and thank you.